to begin this one, but that shot might just get them going.
Young dishes to Landon. Back to Young. And so just over a minute and a half played. And right away, they match it with a three-pointer of their own.
Young knows his range to answer his opponent.
Middleton on the wing. Walker with it. He's picked up by Collins. Back to Walker. For three. Trains the three-pointer.
Both teams running perimeter-oriented plays that are working.
Well, both of them looking towards the three-point line. And I like to see that, especially when the results are made buckets.
And finished off by Collins.
Shooters tend to be hungry, but this time Herder finds an open teammate.
Brown missing.
Well, a lot of players in the league are going to make that shot, and for him, it's pretty much automatic. It's a good defensive effort to prevent the layup.
Collins, good.
The way you keep plays alive is with some effort, and John Collins giving it to you.
It's Walker with the ball, bringing it up for the Boston Celtics. It's a three-point game. Releases. Len grabs the board. And Greg Herder, the 19th pick back in 2018. Sweet touch, and at 6'7". Good size at the shooting guard position.
And the Hawks general manager, Travis Schlink, coming from the Warriors with Trae Young and Kevin Herder. The Hawks hoping they have a kind of Splash Brothers East.
Well, if he's going to keep shooting, they've got to run some plays for him. Screens, pick and rolls, anything they can do to get him started.
Young's shot is off. Last game for the Celtics, they pick up the win against the 76ers. Cantor, the pass to Chain. And there's the pass to Brown. And he banks in the lane.
And that's where Brown is at his best. A muscular beast who loves finishing strong through the contact.
Timeout, timeout.
And now the first timeout called here for the Hawks.
And when Kyle Korver played for Atlanta, he set a league record with at least one three-pointer in 127 consecutive games.
To think that you just wouldn't have one of those nights where nothing was going in.
And we're a little over a minute and a half into the second quarter of action. On the court for the Celtics, Walker in twice the guard. Ogilvy is out there with Jay. He's teed him in at the small forward. Shots good from Young.
That is a tough, tough shot there. Trae Young, such a small player, needs that floater in his arsenal.
And on our sideline, our reporter, David Alden.
Thanks, Kevin. Jay, in the last game against the 76ers, played some superb ball. He had 16 points and a big assist night. Usually not known to be a creator for his teammates. He did a little bit of everything for them. Just seemed like he was everywhere on the floor. Kevin, back to you.
David, he was an attack coach all night long. GA really propelled them to that win.
When he's on, he is on. And there isn't all that much you can do to stop him.
And sometimes you can just look at a guy and you see the confidence that he's playing with. That's what I like best.
Some news now about Jay. He was named Player of the Month for the first time in his terrific young career. Easy to see why when you look at his numbers.
Man, the coach who attacked all month long and led his team to victories can't be ignored. And the NBA got it right in naming Jay Player of the Month. Hard to argue with that decision.
Over in the corner, Brown. To Jay, shot clock at 5. Excellent D there from Parker.
Not really his best quarter as far as scoring. Let's see if he can eventually get back in.
Hunter!
Celtics trail by 5.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
There's Walker with the 3. Rebounded by the Hawks. Parker's got 4 rebounds in this game.
And this is right around the time when one team might start to pull away.
Yeah, this team is looking to add to the lead, trying to put the other team away, and threatening here.
Brown with it. He's picked up by Parker. Brown the pass to Chain. The shot's good. Brown making the play. 7 points for Chain.
Yeah, Che getting smacked around on the inside, brushing it off. That was tough.
Young dishes to Collins. Here's Hurt. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Great D that time from Middleton. Celtics trailed by five. Jay kicks to Middleton. Back to Jay. Nice jump shot from the top of the key. Jay's got 9 points.
Well, Middleton right now staying aware of where his teammates are and hitting them when they're open.
Pass to Herter. Now Parker. A three ball. Here's Collins. Good for the fifth time in 5 shots. He remains perfect.
Three consecutive field goals have come right at the rim. The D had better start buckling down.
The shot will not fall.
And gotta like what they've been doing down low in the post.
Hunter, the pass to Herter. Outside cover. Young in the corner. From outside, off the mark. And that is it for the first half. A
what are you doing out there, Jay? Looks like you're running in the mud.
I got nothing tonight, man.
Okay, let's go back to basics, all right? See your man, see the ball, all right? Make the right pass, take the open shot. All right, you do it.
And as we get into this third quarter, as we've seen so far, neither team able to create much separation on the scoreboard yet. One of the stories here, John Collins getting it done today.
In those first two quarters, he was pretty much an automatic bucket getter if he got it down low on the block.
Yeah, we'll see if the double teams start to come here in the second half to make them adjust offensively. But he's going to keep going at him.
Herter the two with Hunter at the three. Collins a power forward with Lamb at center. And it's Young in at the point guard. That's the group starting the second half for Lloyd Pierce. That one is no good. Brett, so many guys are now shooting from well beyond the arc. Who do you think has the deepest range in the league?
I think Steph Curry has the most consistent, deepest range.
He is Lillard in, is in that category.
Lillard is in there. And of course, last year's playoff win will never go away. What a great memory that was. Trae Young is now entering that category, Kevin.
Yeah,
I mean, we saw
name,
that
right
at the end of last year. His fearlessness in pulling up from just about anywhere has been pretty remarkable. And to that, I will add Lopez, who has found his way well beyond the three-point line.
He's a whole nother conversation.
We'll talk about him later.
We'll do that. And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin. Well, the Hawks said they were going to be patient when they rebuilt their team, and they were going to do it through the draft, and they've stuck to that script. Now, Trae Young is probably the biggest one, but man, he's added a lot of great young talent the last 3 years. There's John Collins, Kevin Herter, and in 2019, the Hawks added 3 more good young players in the draft. DeAndre Hunter, Cam Reddish, and Bruno Fernandez. Things are looking up.
I think so, too. On paper, looks good. We'll see if it materializes. D.A., thank you as always. Time call here. The Hawks decide to talk it over.
And as fans present themselves throughout a game,
Celtics have yet to miss from the free throw line. They're 3 for 3.
Sorry. Shooting one. Under 6.
Free throw good. Murray.
And coming from a background with player development for head coach Lloyd Pierce.
Well, I think he's great at just being a cheerleader and a confidence builder for this young team. I believe that to be a good fit here in Atlanta.
runs a great hands-on approach, and very, very important for him to think about player development as these young guys grow together.
Jaylen Brown checked in for Boston. Cross contact on the shot, and now a three-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
The Hawks have made two of the previous three free throws in today's game.
Well, the leap that we saw John Collins make last year was pretty awesome. Scary thing is he's just going to keep getting better and wants to improve the consistency in terms of his shooting range around the top of the key.
I'd love to see them impose themselves a little more on the backboard. That's a great way to find confidence. Always a surefire way to get back in the game.
And Brent, many consider Trae Young the first product of the Steph Curry generation. In the age of the three-point shot.
I think that's pretty fair. He said he recorded all of Steph Curry's games. He studied them and tried to see where Steph was gaining some advantage. And that balance of his shooting and his playmaking, then moving without the ball, you can see all of those sort of attributes that are coming out of Trae Young, courtesy of Steph Curry.
Here's Parker and the dunk by
Parker. I love how Jabari gets to the rim and goes strong that time up over the top.
5 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. It's good. And the Hawks lead is cut down now to just 9 in the bucket from Shea.
And that assist got him a little nod from his teammate after that one. And really the smart thing would be to hold for the last shot.
Every second right now is valuable to you. That should be their strategy.
The Hawks have made 4 free throws from the line and missed 2.
And Trae Young wants to be a leader, but it's not about wanting. You have to show it on a consistent basis so your teammates start to look towards you.
And that's another area where he is just a superb player. Excellent at the free throw line.
Inside. Takes the assist and lays it in. Pick out the pass nicely. Young's got the lead up to 13 now for Atlanta. Looking for an opening, and it's Boston with another.
Oh, you got a shadow Walker. His mid-range game is on point.
Well, through 3 quarters of play, down double digits, it may be difficult to overcome. Hawks on top, up by 11. And we'll have the start of a fourth quarter for you as soon as we get back from this short break. And how about a look now at our assist of the game, brought to you by State Farm.
And the definition of teamwork right there, guys. I mean, what great communication between them, and what a beautiful feed.
The coaches talk about it all the time, but to be able to play with that kind of feel, nice play, collaborating, improvising, and organic.
And there have been 2 very different performances from these teams today. We get going in quarter number 4. A moment now to reset the lineups, brought to us by Gatorade. All fueled up here for the fourth quarter. On the floor for Boston, Walker and Brown, they're manning the backcourt. Shea is out there with Chris Middleton, and it's Cantor in at the 5 down low. Here's Herter. He's covered by Brown. Shot clock at 6. Herter, no good.
How about the timing he showed there to challenge that shot?
Yeah, not easy to do there, and that's a guy that you can tell takes every possession defensively very seriously.
Back to Jay, launches a 3. Collins grabs the miss. Collins has got rebound number 7 for him tonight.
With him struggling tonight, they need to find some other options out there to keep themselves in the game.
And Walker's got the ball here for Boston. Here in the fourth quarter, their defense has been very strong, allowing no baskets.
Well, the D has done a very poor job at contesting him from outside, guys. He's tearing into them right now, and they cannot stop him.
And Parker, here we go, lays it up off the glass. And the Hawks lead by 8.
Another bucket down low. They've been the aggressors, taking the ball inside and attacking at the rim.
And Walker gets the chain, fires it up, and he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim. Shea's got 10 points in just the second half. Atlanta leading by 6. Young taking his time here. Pass to Collins. excellent D from Cantor. Here's Middleton. Good. And it's Jay picking up the assist. And now just a 4-point Hawks lead. To the middle. Here's Parker. And the layup is good after a nice lead pass.
Someone's open. Trey Young scanning and finds him.
Boston's gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've...
And with Brown, it doesn't matter what point in the game it's at. He's ready to shoot whenever and wherever he has the ball in a good spot.
Young outside. Here's Hurt. Pass to Hunter. Nice ball movement here by Atlanta. Cherry with the block.
Crazy to think scouts were saying that Shea didn't play with enough heart. That block showing you that he wants it.
It's good. Now just a 2-point Hawks lead.
Stella won the ball. Shea wanted it and cashed in.
Time call here. The Hawks decide to talk it over. They're up by two. There's a minute 47 left to play here in the fourth. We've got a moment for Jordan, player of the game, John Collins.
He's been in constant motion, creating a lot of good looks for himself. But still, even when you're wide open, you expect to miss some of the time. Man, that has not been the case here tonight. This guy has made everything.
Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sideline.
Hey, guys. Roy Pierce talked with his team during that last timeout. He said to them, that's the kind of effort we need to bring every night. We're right in this thing. And it's going to take sustained effort to close it out. Now let's bring it home. Kevin, back to you.
Jay head down, nose down, wanting to get in there. Not afraid to dribble in, earn some foul shots.
He hits the first one, and that narrows the gap to one. That one drops. He ties it up.
Yeah, nice there. He does not waste those opportunities. Just what they needed with this game still in doubt.
1:11 left in the game. Goes up to the stripe. Young's shot is off. The Celtics have gone 6 of 9 on their field goal attempts since the start of the fourth quarter. It drops.
Remember that one. Guys, a difference maker.
I'm wondering, Greg, is that the biggest shot of the game?
The ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Len.
Celtics ball.
There's 37 seconds left in the fourth quarter. I think we'll see them burn the clock a bit here.
Yeah, smart move.
Shea with it. Working on Collins. Shea's shot is off.
And the pressure he put on that shot forced the miscue.
Those are all the little things about effort there. He just gets out there and contests, and that's just enough.
Atlanta calls timeout. They trail by two. 23 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. It's been a pretty tough stretch for them.
And this will be an important possession. It's really essential. They put a stop to this run, and the best way to do it is by great execution.
Here's Young. Can't cash in. Hunter, the pass to Len. Here's Herter. Here's Young. Count it! That is a huge basket right there.
And since Trey Young comes up huge this time, looking like the go-to guy.
Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. Sports back in a moment here in Atlanta. And now we get to tip. It's Boston. And no shortage of excitement here. We're officially underway in overtime in this game. All fueled up and ready to go to overtime basketball here. Brought to us by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. On the court for Atlanta. Collins at power forward with Lynn at center. Pettish out there with Young. And it's Parsons in at the three. Back to Collins. Makes it off the glass. Collins has got the first basket here in overtime for the Hawks.
Interesting night when you're getting this kind of production from Collins. They're going to lean on him a little bit more now.
And wrestling for it there, but no one has possession. He'll have a jump ball. Celtics off the tip, and away we go here with post-regulation basketball, and stolen by Chay. Smart on the wing, right side Tatum, beyond the arc, and he's good on the free ball, and the Celtics lead by one.
And Tatum's experience in these spots is starting to show. He's never been afraid to take the biggest shots.
Time call here. The Hawks decide to talk it over. Comes in for Reddish. And the Celtics also making a change. Brown's checked in. Here's Len. He kicks to Hunter. Outside Collins. Feeds it to Len. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
You got to be more cautious when you're guarding Alex Len. Obviously, his size puts you at an immediate disadvantage.
Two shots.
And so both free throws go in time.
How about the composure there at the line? A ton of pressure on those free throws, and he knocks them both in.
Now, timeout called by Boston. They're trailing by one. 149 left to play. The pass to Chain. Rebounded by the Hawks. Now, here is Young. And he finishes nicely. Come on. By Brown. And it's now 26 points for Jay. And here's Young. He'll bring it up for the Atlanta Hawks. Lobbed up there for Collins. Oh, and they get in the way of the alley-oop. Not to be. Good play defensively. Here's Walker. Hunter grabs the miss.
How about the timing? He shows there to challenge that shot.
Yeah, not easy to do there, and that's a guy that you can tell takes every possession defensively very seriously.
Chay drives in. It's in!
Chay stepping up. Feed that man.
Hawks have gone 2-3 from the floor as we've gotten this overtime period underway. Walker against Young. Count the basket. Kemba Walker picks one up.
Just been brilliant today, guys, and it was the same exact story last time out.
And not the guy that you want to put at the line in these moments. He's not missing it.
Takes the three. That one misses. And Atlanta will go the other way. Here's Herbert.
For a miracle worker out there is the opposing coaching staff. I don't know that they have one. This game seems to be well in hand.
Now, timeout called by Boston. They're down by four. 19 seconds left in overtime. Brown the pass to Chain. From deep three-point range, but they recover it. Good! And what a sensational bucket to bring them within one.
And the three-point shot is something that Brown continues to improve upon. It's important for him to be draining these looks. He had to foul.
So he gets them both, and it's a three-point game.
That last one was a difference maker. It pushed it from a two-point lead to three.
And no secret here, guys. They've got to get a three. We're going to get yet another overtime.
Shea, left side. And so the big run by Aaron in the top game. And a straight to push it to overtime, but they really